Hello and welcome back. Today we're going to look at the dividend discount model, which is a way of computing a value of a stock. So in the previous video, Anders showed you how to value bond, and bonds then are debt for the company. In this video, we will find the stock value from the cash flows coming to a stock. And the cash flows coming to a stock are called dividends. So when a company pays money to the shareholders, it's called a dividend. And this model then that we're going to use is called the dividend discount model. Okay, so here's some short repetition. When you had bonds, it was fairly simple to compute them, because then when you buy the bond, it's pre-specified what they're going to pay. So you're given a coupon every year. So a coupon here, a coupon here, a coupon here, a coupon here, and a coupon until the end of the bond's life. And they are all equally large, so you could take them all at once. Use the present value of an annuity and get the value of them. And then in the end, as the bond matures, you was receiving a face value, which is a single cash flow, so you move that alone. And then you can compute the present value of all these and you find the price of the bond. But today we're going to look at stock or equity shares. And we start by talking a little bit about what it is. So, common stock, which is what we will focus on today, represents ownership in a company. So you have a part of the ownership of a company. It usually gives you voting rights and therefore some control of the company. So you can, for example, vote on who's going to sit on the board and in that way affect the management of the company. Also, from the company perspective, equity or then stocks represents a permanent source of funds. So when you start by investing equity in a company, they don't have to repay it, and they probably can't repay all of it either. So it's some fund which they always will have, and they can also choose never to repay anything. If you own common stock, then you have the right to income. So if the company makes profits year after year, you are entitled to a share of that. But they have what is called a residual claim, and that means that everyone else who have a claim money from the company will receive their money first. So for example, if the company take a loan at the bank, then you need to pay the interest rate to the bank first before you can give anything to the shareholders. And this also means in case of trouble, so let's say that the company loses all its value and goes bankrupt, well, then everyone else has a priority of getting money from the company, and only if there's anything left after that, then the shareholders can get anything. So this is what we mean by residual claim. And like I said, the company has no obligations to pay dividends. So dividend is the only real cash flow that you get from the company, and the company can choose to simply not do it. Of course, you can elect the managers and that way influence it, but in general, they don't have to pay the dividends. But if you invest money in stocks, then you have what is called a limited liability. So if you invest your money, then you can lose all of your investment, but you cannot be liable and be forced to pay for anything beyond that. So let's say I invest 1,000 crowns in a company and it goes bankrupt. Well, I lose my investment, but in case there's nothing enough left to honor the debt holders, like bondholders or banks, then me as an owner doesn't have to step in with more money to provide to them. So I have limited liability in that sense. And other names then, they can be called equity shares, equity securities, equities, and probably some other names as well. Okay, so let's take some more terminology, but with an example in this case. Assume that you buy a stock today for $50. In 1 year's time, you receive a dividend of $150, and you then sell the stock for $50.5. What is your return here? Okay, so this is like general terminology that we will, that we will use. So P0 here is the price at time zero, so the price today. P1 is the price next year, in 1 year's time, so in this case it was 50.50 and P0 was 50. And Div1, Div stands for dividend, and 1 is then the dividend in year 1 or period 1. So in our case, we had here was P1, 50 was P0, and 1.50 was the dividend in year 1. Okay, so what kind of returns do we make here? Well, first of all, we can see how much money do we get in period one. Okay, so we get 50.50 from selling the stock, And then we get 1.50 from the dividend, so that's a total of $52. And it cost 50 when we bought it, so the total return to us is 52 minus 50, so that's a gain of 2. And we divide it by what we purchased it for, and it gives us a return of 4%, or 0.04. Okay, but we can divide this, so we can take the dividend part for itself and the increase in price for itself. So how much was the dividend part? Well, the dividend part was 1.50. We divide it by 50 and we get 3%. And then we had the price increase. So the price in 1 year's time was 50.50. When we purchased it, it was 50. So the price increased by 50 cents. And we divide it by 50 and find that this increase was 1%. So we see that this total return of 4% consists of a dividend part of 3% and an increase in the price of 1%. This is called then the dividend yield. So the dividend yield is the return you get from the dividend. And it's simply equal to the dividend, the next dividend, divided by the current price. Then we have the capital gain. And capital gain then represents the increase in price. So in this case, the capital gain that we received was P1 minus P0 divided by P0. So it's simply, if you have a price increase, then you have a capital gain. And then we have something called the total return. And the total return is just the sum of them, the dividend yield and the capital gain. So how much money did you make on this investment? Okay. So now we're going to look at one period at a time. So we say that if you buy a stock, then you buy it today and you hold it for one period, and after that you sell it again to someone else. So what do we get in that case? Well, we pay a price, which we call P0 today, so that is what we pay. And then in 1 year's time we might receive a dividend, or maybe it's zero, and we also receive the selling price. So this could of course be lower than what we buy it for, and then we make a loss perhaps, but it could also be positive. Anyway, it's a positive inflow in year one. Okay, but what happens in, I mean, who buys this? So when I sell it to someone else, and that someone else pays for something. What does that person pay for? Well, then we can do the same thing. In year one, someone pays a price, P1, in order to receive something 1 period ahead in the second year, and they receive a dividend that year as well as a selling price, the P2 then. And whoever is buying it in period two is also buying, I mean, to receive something. What does that person receive? Well, it's the same argument. You pay a price, P2, in period two, to receive one dividend in the next period as well as a selling price in the third year. And I mean, I could go on doing the same thing, but I think you get the picture by now. Okay, so let's make this a little bit more formal. We always said that if we want to value something like the bonds, we took the future cash flows and then we discount it back until today. So in the case of our stock, we pay a price P0, and that price should be the present value of the expected dividend plus the expected value of the price that we receive. So these are the two things that we get. So that was the dividend yield, and this was the, well, that's not actually the capital gain, but it's the part. Okay, and in the same way we can find what is the person in period one paying for. So whoever is paying P1 does it to receive the dividend in year two and the selling price in year two. And again, we discount it by 1 plus RE. Sorry, maybe I should mention that this RE is the cost of equity. So it's the discount rate used by the owner of the shares. But since we only have a one period model, we don't take this to the power 2. Okay, so the dividend comes in year 2, but you buy it in year 1. So there's only 1 year between when you pay for it and when you receive it. Therefore, there's no to the power 2 here. Okay, but what we can do now, we have an expression for P1 here, and we have P1 here. So we could take this entire expression for P1 And if we say insert it or replace P1 here by the value of P1 as it is expressed down there. If we do that, it looks like this. So this now here corresponds, this is the old P, sorry. This is the old P1. Okay, that was very close. Let's do it like this. Ah, okay, anyway, this part corresponds to the old P1. And then by some mathematical manipulation or mathematical magic, maybe you think, we can rewrite this so it looks like this instead. So the price in the today should be equal to the present value of the dividend in 1 year's time plus the present value of the dividend in the second year. And now, as you see, here they're suddenly to the power 2. So since it's the price today and we discounting the dividend in 2 years' time, we have to take it to the power 2. And then we also have the selling price in the second year. That's also received 2 years from now, which is why we take to the power 2 when we're discounting it. Okay, but why can't we do this one more time? I mean, this selling price here, P2, it should also be equal to the dividend received the year after and the price received the year after, as we showed in the picture earlier. And again, this is discounted from year 3 to year 2, so it's only 1 year, and therefore there's no to the power 3 here or anything. Okay, what can we do then? Well, we can take this whole expression and we can replace P2 with this expression. If we do that and simplify it again, we get an expression here. So the price today is equal to the present value of the dividend year 1, the present value of the dividend year 2, the present value of the dividend year 3, and the present value of the price year 3. But the price year 3 should be equal to the dividend in year 4 and the price in year 4, etc. So I can continue this as long as I want. And we can show this maybe in a picture instead. So the price today should equal to the present value of the dividend next year and the price next year. Just 1 second. But this price could be replaced by the dividend year 2 and the price in year 2. And this price could be replaced by the dividend in year 3 and the price in year 3. And this price could be replaced, etc. We can go on and go on and go on. And eventually we find that the price today should be equal to the present value of all dividends that will ever be received from this company. So that's basically what the dividend discount model says. The value or the price of a stock today is the present value of all future dividend payments. Okay, so we have a little bit of assumptions here. We assume that the firm will exist forever when we're going to do calculations later. And we're also going to assume that at some point we have a constant growth in the dividend. So there's a annual percentage growth every year. This is just, otherwise it would be very hard to actually calculate the price. Okay, so we can end with an example. Let us estimate the value of a stock which has the following estimates and the cost of equity equal to 13%. So the dividend in 1 year's time is going to be $1 and it will grow by 10% the next year. And after the second dividend, it will grow at a constant rate of 2% per year. Okay, so we could compute then that the first year was $1. The next year it should grow by 10%, so it would be then 1 times 1 plus 0.10, which is $1.1. So that's, I've already done it here. And then don't know yet what the dividend in year 3 and year 4 is, but I do know that I will have a growth rate of 2% every year. So what is the present value of this one? Well, I said we should compute the present value of all of them, discounted today. So for the first one, we will take it alone because it's only $1. The second one, we will also take alone. And then from year 3 and onwards, we have a constant growth rate of 2% per year. So this is what you call a growing perpetuity. And you've seen how to compute the value of that. So we can take all of these at once with one step, and then we'll take it all the way back until today. So the present value of the first two, so let's take the dividend one and dividend two. Then the present value would be 1 divided by 1 plus 0.13 to the power of 1. This is from the first year. And then we add 1.10 divided by 1 plus 0.13 to the power of 2. It's from here. And if you compute the present value of that, it will turn out to be 1.746. Okay. What is then the present, the third dividend, the dividend 3? Well, the dividend 3 is found by, we knew that the second year's dividend was 1.1. And we also knew that it would grow by 2% per year. So we take 1.1 times 1.02. And we find this dividend to be 1.122, it should be. Okay, how did we compute the present value of a growing perpetuity? Well, we took the cash flow, so the dividend is 1.122. We divide it by the interest rate, or the cost of equity, minus the growth rate of 2%. And we find this to be 12.466, etc. And this is then given in year 2. Okay, so that's the first jump when we go here. All right, so we need to move this from year 2 until today. So we take the value, which was then 12.4666, and then we divide it by 1 plus the cost of equity to the power of 2, since we need to move it 2 years. And this is then 9.763. So the total value of this stock is then, so P0 is equal to 9.763. plus the value of these two first dividends, which we had in the previous slide. It was 1.746. So plus 1.746. And we see that the total value of this stock is 11.51, approximately. Okay, so then we know what the value of this stock is, and we have now learned how to compute the price of a single stock using the dividend discount model. Okay, so just a short summary. Stocks represents ownership in a firm. So if you own a stock, you have a part of the ownership. The value of a stock, according to this model, is the present value of all future dividends. And that's it for this video. See you in the next one.